Page 24, 外婆家的超级市场。我八岁时来到乡下的外婆家，虽然生活困苦，但外婆幽默乐观，和她在一起。 Grandma's supermarket. I came to my grandma's house in the countryside when I was 8 years old. Although life is difficult, grandma is humorous and optimisticBeing with her, 让我感受到生活的乐趣和幸福。读一读故事和外婆的话，你可以从外婆身上学到什么。Makes me feel the joy and happiness of life. Read the story and grandma's words. What can you learn from grandma?
外婆家门前有一条河，河面上架着一根木棍，都是外婆用来拦截河上飘来的东西的。河的上游有个市场。
There was a river in front of Grandma's house, and a wooden stick stood on the river, which was used by Grandma to intercept.Things floating on the river. There is a market in the upper reaches of the river.
卖菜的人把一些卖不出去的蔬菜丢进河里。这些蔬菜飘下来，被木棍拦住了。外婆捡起这些形状不好看。
The sellers throw some unsold vegetables into the river. The vegetableFloated down and were stopped by wooden sticks. Grandma picked up these ugly shapes.
The 蔬菜说，开叉的萝卜切成小块，煮出来味道一样。弯曲的小黄瓜做成泡菜，味道也一样。的确是这样。
Vegetables and said, split radishis cut into small pieces, and it tastes the same when cooked. The cooked cucumber is made into kimchi, and the taste is the same. It is true.
Page 24, 外婆家的超级市场。我八岁时 ,Page 25,还有一些水果因为皮破了一点或裂开了被丢进河里，但是外婆说这是外表差一点儿。
Some fruits were thrown into the river because the skin was a little broken or cracked, but my grandmother said it's just a little bit on the outside.
切开来吃味道也一样，真的是这样。外婆称那条河是我们家的超级市场，是送货上门的，还不收运费呢。
It tastes the same when you cut it up. This is true, Grandma said. The river is our supermarket. It is delivered to your door and there is no shipping fee.
她说，有时候木棍什么也没拦到。他就叹口气说，今天超市休息了，有一次河上飘来一只很新的木屐。
She said, sometimes the wooden stick didn't stop anything. She sighed and said, today the supermarket is closed. Once, a very new clock floated on the river.
只有一只怎么穿，当柴烧吧。他说
Page 26,
我正要把木屐扔进火里，他又说再等两三天吧。
Only one how to wear it as firewood, she said. I was about to throw the wooden clock into the fire, and she said, wait 2 or 3 days.
另一只也会飘下来的。我想不会这么幸运吧，可是
两三天后，另一只木鸡真的飘下来了，吓了我一跳。The other one will float down. I don't think it is so lucky. But two or three days later, the other clock is really floated down, and I am surprised. Page 26. 一只木鸡掉进河里后，那个人一时还舍不得扔掉另一只，但是过两三天他就会死心，把另一只也扔进河里。After one clock fell into the river, that person couldn't get rid of the other one for a while, but after two or three days, he would give up and throw the other one too into the river.
这样你就得到一双啦。我觉得外婆简直就是一个预言家。外婆说过的话可以只有可以捡来的东西。
In this way, you will get a pair. I think Grandma is simply a prophet. What Grandma said was only things that could be picked up.
没有应该扔掉的东西。别老是怪天气冷啊热的，夏天时要感谢。冬天时要感谢夏天。
Nothing that should be thrown away. Don't always blame the cold or hot weather. Thankful for winter in summer, thankful for summer in winter.
伤心的事不要在晚上说，等到白天再说也就不算什么了。
Don't talk about sad things at night. Wait until the daytime. It's nothing.
本文改编自岛田洋七的《霍佐的超级阿姨》陈宝莲译。
This article is adapted from Saga's Super Grandma by Shimada Yuch, translated by Chen Baolian. Page 26.
一只